Hello and welcome back to the channel. If you're new here, I'm Ron. Today I have something a little different for you. It's kind of a vlog style video. And in this video, I'm going to be riding my one-wheel XR around Sandy Hook beaches here in New Jersey. That's where I live. We finally got some decent weather here in New Jersey and it reached about 60 degrees, that's Fahrenheit, just the other day. We've been averaging about 40 degrees in New Jersey. So we're starting to actually feel like a little bit of spring around here, which is absolutely great. And more importantly, that summer's finally coming. I don't know about you, but I've been feeling a lot like that 1993 classic movie Groundhog Day with Bill Murray. And I mean, is anyone else feeling like you're on a hamster wheel lately? Just a lot of the same mundane things the past few months, day in and day out. I just can't wait until the COVID thing's behind us and we can start feeling normal again. Maybe it also has something to do with winter that we just had, but man, I'm looking forward to summer. So just being outside today and riding, it was really nice. So most of the snow that we had around here finally melted. I can finally enjoy my one wheel once again. I actually took the day off from work to go out and enjoy the weather and just have a little fun. Just a mental health day for me, and I really feel like I needed it. Today, I packed up not only my one wheel, but some other camera gear, including my Sony a7 III camera and my two of my GoPros, a GoPro 7 and a GoPro 9 as well, and a few of my FPV quads, hoping to actually fly today, and more about that in a minute. So one of the things I really love about riding is the exploring, or a bit of adventure, you could call it. I can really cover a lot of ground on this thing in a very short amount of time. And for those of you who don't know, this model of one wheel that I'm riding covers a distance of about 12 to 18 miles on a single charge. You can hit top speeds around 19 to 20 miles an hour, though I tend to keep mine around 15 miles per hour on average, and it fully charges in less than an hour. The XR is just a great electric board, and I'm always finding a little adventure when I'm out riding it. I hope you'll stay to the end of this video because I ran into something a little out of the norm today while riding. Oh, and if you want to skip ahead, I did create chapters below, but I hope you'll watch the entire video. You'll get a really good idea of how big this park actually is. Again, we're here in New Jersey. So if you've never been to Sandy Hook, New Jersey, it's a pretty cool place to check out. Yeah, it's even got a nude beach at the far end, but we're not going to talk about that today. I'm trying to keep my content PG, so I hope you appreciate that. And if you watched the news recently, this is actually the stretch of beach that Bruce Springsteen got his DWI in. I'm not exactly sure why he got arrested, because his blood alcohol level was 0.02, which is actually a quarter of the state's legal limit of 0.08. Pretty sure it had something to do with the fact that the park rangers said they saw him take two shots of alcohol being offered by some fans at the time, and then had him riding off on his motorcycle. Sandy Hook Park is a national recreation area on federal land, and alcohol has been prohibited since 2019. So if you're in this park, just know to leave the alcohol at home. Also, I read that even though the New Jersey laws refers to the 0.08% blood alcohol level, that you can still be convicted of driving while under the influence when your blood alcohol level is below 0.08%. That's according to a statement on the Attorney General's website in New Jersey. I didn't know that until recently, so just a heads up. If you don't believe me, I'll also leave a link below and you can read that off the New Jersey statute website for yourself. And I feel like that's one of those the more you know commercials. So just a heads up that you can't fly your drones here. It's all restricted airspace, and because it's a national recreation area, it's also restricted. So trust me, you don't want to even think about flying here. You'll see commercial aircraft flying and making turns coming into New York here all the time. The beach is literally just on the other side of New York City and some major international airports like JFK and LaGuardia. And you can actually see New York City from the beaches here when you're hanging out there. Just to give you a little more perspective, here's an aerial shot that I pulled off the web. I didn't take this shot myself, but just to give you a little perspective, I'm about here when I started this video. Just on the other side of the bridge as you're coming into Sandy Hook, and I'm going to be riding down to the Sandy Hook Lighthouse in this video. If you've never been here, the beaches are free to access during the winter, and then they start charging a $15 fee, I believe, starting around Memorial Day weekend until Labor Day. Or you can do like my wife and I do and get a season pass, which used to be $75, but I think they recently raised it to, I don't know, a few dollars more. I believe the actual distance from start to finish is about 7 miles. And you've got the ocean on one side of you with beaches and the bay on the other. So you're surrounded by water on both sides. The water being on both sides is really nice if you're down here riding your one wheel, biking, jogging, or just hanging out. The wife and I come down here quite a bit. The sunsets are okay, in my opinion, but nothing great compared to places like Wildwood or Cape May, New Jersey, in my opinion. I've also heard you'll stumble across the occasional snowy white owl here in the winter, though I've yet to see one personally at this location. If you follow me on Instagram, you know the wife and I photographed some snowy owls in Maine earlier this year. So I'm just gonna do a little cruising now and let you guys take in the scenery. Further in this video, I stumbled across some harbor seals. So just stay tuned for that. No seal expert, so I'm pretty sure that they're actually harbor seals based on the shape of their noses from what I've been able to research. I've never seen seals in Sandy Hook before, but others say they have seen them from time to time. So if you want to see a few pictures from the other day, keep watching. I actually had my wife come down with a better camera lens and had her shoot most of these shots. The seals were pretty far out on some rocks. And if you ever photograph seals, just know they're kind of hard to shoot because of their color. Everything just kind of blends together, making it hard to get a lot of detail in your shots between, you know, the eyes, the nose, and the mouth. It just kind of all blends together. I think you need a really strong lens, or really need to be right on top of these guys to really get some great distinguishing features to show in your photos. I follow one guy on Instagram and he's got some great shots, but I know he's out in a kayak most of the day and has a great lens to boot. I was planning on shooting some FPV footage as well, though not here in Sandy Hook. Just want to throw that out. Although the temperature was really nice, the winds were gusting upwards of 20 to 25 miles an hour. Plus, so I just wasn't feeling comfortable putting my FPV out there on the day that I was doing this ride. I am planning on doing some FPV flying this weekend, weather permitting, of course, but March in New Jersey isn't making things very easy to get that FPV footage that I'm shooting for. I really want to get some beach footage with my FPVs. That's really what the goal was. I did manage to get a little FPV flying in the other day during my lunch break at the office. I'll share that video with you guys as well, and enjoy the rest of the video. Please don't forget to like, subscribe, ring that bell. It really does help the channel. So until next time, be safe, and we'll see you guys in the next video.
Thank you.